Hello, White Memorial family. We're so glad you're joining us today. Well, as you can see, it's Christmas time, and we hope that this time you remember that Christmas is about Jesus and all the beautiful things that He's done for our lives. Today, we're going to be dedicating this service to our facility department. Thank you so much for all they do, for fixing everything around the hospital. Without you, we wouldn't be able to perform and do our service to our community. So now, please bow your head as we pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for your love and care. Thank you for allowing us to be here today, Father, as we celebrate you, Jesus. We celebrate Christmas time with our families and our loved ones, Father. We're just going to ask you a special blessing for our facilities department, that you can bless them, Father. You can give them all the tools and resources they need, Father, to be able to keep serving our community, Father. We love you, God, and thank you so much for all you've done in our lives, and thank you for all the things that you still will do in the future, Father. We love you, God, and thank you for everything you do. In your name we pray, amen. Well, now let's worship together.
I read a stat this week that 1 in 3 Americans have reported symptoms of anxiety or depression during the pandemic. When things are bad, you start to get tunnel vision on your problems. You start to doubt things will get better, and that weight can submerge you. That feeling can actually be paralyzing. This year has been tough, and for sure tougher for some. It's a strange time to be alive. I noticed that strangeness while watching old movies and noticing the crowds, the hugs, the high fives. That makes me sad. But there is reason to have hope. There is reason to believe God will surprise you with something in your near future. And I'm not just talking about a vaccine only. You and I shouldn't doubt God's plan for our life. Just because you don't understand it or see it doesn't mean it's not part of the story. I have a 4-year-old daughter, and often I don't understand her, no matter how much she tries to communicate or I lean forward and try to get what she's trying to say. But a couple weeks ago, she asked me with a very straightforward face, she wanted a crustable, and I had no idea what she was saying. I should have gotten the hint because I was in front of the refrigerator, but my 9-year-old, almost 10-year-old, and he knows it, said, "Dad, she wants an uncrustable." Which, if you don't know, is a peanut butter jelly sandwich without the crust on it. Pretty good late night snack. Not a meal, though. Very important. But I went from complete confusion to complete understanding of what my daughter was trying to say in that very moment. And that often happens in moments of our life, too. This is why God often reminds us to remember past times that God has delivered or God has come through. So you and I always trust Amazon to deliver, but we often don't trust God to deliver in those confusing moments. And we do that because we forget. We get tunnel vision on our problems. We need to stop doubting what God can do and get ready for God to do something where He's going to surprise you with an even better future than you could ever imagine. I think about the story of Naomi in the Bible. She was married, had 2 sons, moved to a new area for a better opportunity, in a matter of months, everything is taken away from her. Her husband died, her two sons died, and now she had to move back home alone to nothing. Talk about a dark moment. But before her trip home, she told her daughter-in-laws that they could leave. They had no obligation to her, the ex-mother-in-law. And one of the daughter-in-laws did something surprising and surprised Naomi in her response. And that woman's name is Ruth. You should read about her story in the Old Testament. It's really easy to find because the book name is Ruth, so table of contents, Ruth. But Ruth's faithfulness leads to a new and better future than Naomi could ever think of at that moment of dread. Everything was over to Naomi. If it was up to Naomi's planning, everything was done, but God surprised her through Ruth's faithfulness. It's easy in times of trouble to think we're at the end of the story. But from God's perspective, he's just getting started with us. Before there's any big finale, there needs to be a big conflict. If you just wait a few more scenes, the payoff is just around the corner. I know many of us want to fast forward. We shouldn't. We got to wait. I'm not sure how good or bad your year has been, but I do know that God is not done with your movie yet or your show yet. We are in a time of year that involves the biggest surprise ever. The God of the universe came to earth for you and me. That God, yes, the God of the universe, wants to not only know you, but he wants to do amazing things through you. And we get to be part of that. I love that part. God wants to activate us. So don't forget what God has already done in your life by remembering past times God has delivered. Think Amazon. If you trust Amazon, you can trust God. And start betting on and realizing that God wants to do something amazing for you in this life, coming up in this new year. I'm praying that your big surprise happens very soon. Check out the story of Ruth for some encouragement this week. And Merry Christmas.
One Zamora family, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen.